Here at Dobec Performance, we have been using load-based technology for years now. It is surprising to us that Dynojet and others are still confused with how this is possible. They explain to their potential customers that we must be using magic. This is flattering. However, we feel that people deserve a better idea of what it means to possess load-based technology. The old way of understanding load was to use alpha N, throttle position versus RPM. This was developed back in the 1950s and introduced in 1957 on a Rambler car. It is ignorant to assume that you can get the most out of your EFI controller by using alpha N. For example, it simply does not understand the difference between 100% throttle in first gear at 6,000 RPM and 100% in fourth gear at 6,000 RPM. We will quickly demonstrate for you that our box is in fact load-based. It does not guess the load, and it is not a low, mid, or high RPM fuel interface, as our competitors have stated. To do this demonstration, we have a 2006 GSXR 1000, a TEXA scan tool used to display the current throttle position and RPM, a Dobec Performance dynamometer creating uphill roll-on, and we have installed our EFI control box and an Innovate Motorsports LM2 displaying the air-fuel ratio. This clip simply shows a sixth gear roll-on maintaining approximately 7,000 RPM, and as the throttle is opened and closed, our lights move through the full load range. The lights displaying green for cruise, yellow for mid-range load, and red for full load. If we were an RPM-based box, we could not understand how load changes as the throttle is turned. Please feel free to email us with your questions regarding our methods of mapping. Tech@dobecperformance.com.